So the first thing that we'll be doing is importing our model. I already created this geo node, like as a geometry node. Inside of it, I'll be creating a file node. And we'll be importing the OBJ file that I exported from ZBrush. It's called GeoSymbiotesCalTVs. As you can see, it's kind of flipped around. It's not the correct orientation scale, and that's normal. But it has some UVs. You can see the UVs here. You can see the groups. I have 5 groups in the model. And we have UVs, so the first thing we'll be fixing the transforms of this model. So we'll be centering it to centroid, so we align it to the 0, 0 of the world. I'll be flipping also the model 90 degrees on the x-axis and 180 in the z-axis. This is how I've done it before. So we'll be also scaling it 100 times, so it's really small. As you know, in Houdini, the grid is the big squares are 1 meter, and the smaller one are 20 centimeters because the spacing is 20. You can see and change that here when you right click on the display reference plane grid. You see reference plane parameters, and you see the spacing here. It's 0.2, which means 0.02 meters, 20 centimeters. You can change it if you want. So, we'll be working with the scale. It's around 40 centimeters in length. Now we'll be cleaning up because if you check the model, you have some useless parameters, color coming from ZBrush, which I don't really have, a mask that you can paint with the brush in ZBrush and can be exported with the OBJ file, and the shop material path, which is a standard primitive attribute that assigns materials to objects. Also, we have the UVs that I showed you earlier, and the 5 groups. As you can see, the groups they're coming from ZBrush are always kind of messed up. You have a group prefix and a bunch of random numbers that are assigned internally by ZBrush to each model. These are called the polygroups in ZBrush. They're made manually when you kind of split your model into different pieces. And this is what I usually do when I export in ZBrush. I always do polygroups just so I could have a model that is split in different pieces that are easier to handle here in Houdini. It's more difficult to kind of split it in Houdini. So what we'll be doing is renaming these groups because we need to have a regular like a correct name for each group. We're going to be dropping a group rename, and then in the group rename I'm going to be doing 5 renames because I have 5 groups. So basically input the names of the groups in each of these fields, and then we're going to be renaming it specifically in this order. So GRP, I usually use this prefix GRP, means group, like 001. I'm going to copy this 002, 003, group tail, and GRP body. So now we have 5 primitive groups that are properly named. And I'll be cleaning also the useless parameters with an attribute delete. You can do the cleaning with in 2 ways. So either attribute delete, and you remove the shop material path, and these parameters, color and mask, that we don't need. You either do this, or if you want to clean up the some useless attributes, and at the same time you want to delete some groups, you can use the clean SOP, which is a really cool SOP that I like a lot. But you have to be careful and uncheck some of these checkboxes. Remove degenerate primitives and unused points. This checkbox usually creates a lot of problems in models. Sometimes when you don't have proper connectivity, it's going to be trying to delete some primitives, and you'll end up with a lot of holes in the model. So you uncheck both of these. Especially, you know, the remove unused points, what it does, it just removes any points that are floating in space and don't have any connectivity to other points. So you have a particle system, and you apply the clean node, it's going to just remove all the points from your simulation. I check these ones, I remove attributes and the groups at the same time, so it's a completely clean model, but this is not the goal. The goal is just to remove the useless parameters. So yeah, we remove these ones, and we're going to be calculating some normals that we're going to be using a lot in the flip. And flip solver. So I do vertices, sometimes I do points, so I'm gonna leave it at points because I wanna have a point attribute, point normal attribute. Also I'm gonna be naming, like outputting a null, which will be pointing to this clean model. Out mesh clean quads. So as you can see, it's a clean model, everything's good, looks good. And if you can see, you wanna see the wireframe, it's kinda like this. It's quads generated by the remesher it's not the clean remesher from ZBrush, it's another tool that generates just quads, not all quads, but still, it's a usable model. At the time, I was using this one, but today I would have remeshed this with the Z remesher, and it would have been even cleaner than this. But I wanted to preserve some details. Sometimes you either do like a very dense remesh, or you can decimate the tools from ZBrush. Basically, triangulate your model and preserve all the folds and creases and all the details that are on the model. You can do this if you don't want to apply any displacement maps, but I have a displacement map already generated for the shading part. So it comes from ZBrush. I generated it in ZBrush. All right. So yeah. So this is the prep stage, and I'm going to be switching now to the grouping stage of these bubbles. This is, I think, the most time-consuming task in the prep stage. So yeah, let's see what we can do with this in the next lesson.